Problem with that.
What is it about this story that you think will be attractive to audiences?
I think it's a story ultimately about any adversity that we face. I mean, it's a spiritual odyssey. It's a anyone who faces disease, who faces, even in peacetime, there are adversity. Yeah, it's about your spirit. What do you do with your, how do you deal with life? How do you react to life and all the problems that life brings? This woman has seen all degrees of suffering, has seen all the sides of men, has carried with her much man hatred. There's a monk in the film who accuses her also of having man hatred.
Let me talk about the casting a little second. You found a young woman to play Lele, who had not acted
ever. Never been in a high school play or anything.
She came either with herself or with a friend to an open opportunity to meet with representatives of the film. Were you there?
No, I was not at the first audition. Yeah. We auditioned 18,000 Vietnamese all over the country.
Yeah.
We sent out casting crews, put them on tape. She walked in, and the casting people were thought
locked
she had charisma.
Yeah,
and put her on tape. Flew her to Los Angeles. I met her. She walked in the room. She was spectacular. She was about 4'11", 95 pounds, but she had a great beauty about her. She had beautiful eyes. She had a great spunk and spirit. She'd been a boat person.
She
grew up in a poor family here in America. Her family had, at that time, was on welfare, and she had this wonderful smile. She just encompassed the room with that smile. It wasn't too hard to follow up with that, and we tested her many times on video and on film. We put her in with Joan Chen and with Tommy Lee Jones,
Joan
who
Chen,
was about three
right.
times her size, and Hang Noor, from Killing Fields.
Right.
And they were professional, and they helped bring her up. We were nervous. The whole film rides on her shoulders.
Sure. And she performs magnificently.
We went out to Asia, and we started shooting, and we kept our fingers crossed.
Yeah. Set this film up. It's a Don't Want a New Boyfriend. What is this clip that we're going to see?
This is halfway through the movie. She meets she's in Saigon, and she's working as a hostess in a Korean bar, and she meets Tommy Lee Jones, who's a GI on the street. And he follows her home, and he tells her, he's persistent, he wants to meet her, and he wants to talk to her. She doesn't really want to meet him because she doesn't like men at this point of her life.
Roll tape, here it is.
Hi. Well, I hope you don't mind if I stretched out for a while. That chair got kind of uncomfortable.
You still here?
You said I could rest, and I didn't want to take you out to dinner to thank you for your hospitality.
You know, under Sitan, I know what go dinner.
Oh, well, then we'll just go for a walk or for a drink. It doesn't matter to me.
I want you, Didi. You nice man, but I know one boyfriend.
You have a boyfriend?
Dingy dao. No, no boyfriend. Me had boyfriend. But me no want new boyfriend.
Sorry. Sounds like he hurt you very much.
Yes.
Beg your pardon?
You want me to give you money for taxi?
Oh, no. No, I'm perfectly content right here.
I know. I know you want to stay here, but this my house. You want woman, I got sick low.
I told you I'm not interested in prostitutes. I'm interested in you. Is this your little brother?
What?
Is this handsome little boy your relative?
My son.
Oh, of course he is. He looks just like you. There's a lot of spirit around the eyes.
Steve.
Yeah.
Is that your name?
Yeah.
I'm sorry I'm not very nice to you. You want some tea?
Yeah.
Tommy Lee Jones, worked with him. He played Clay Shaw in JFK. First lead, first romantic lead, as far as you know?
Well, since Coal Miner's Daughter, when he was with Sissy,
right.
this is a role for him where...
What is it about
he's
him
tender.
That somehow...
It's an interesting character. He's a bit like America itself in Vietnam. I mean, he's reaching out to help her. He wants to meet an Oriental wife, and he marries her. He brings her back to San Diego, and it looks like it's going to be a happy ending. And things are tough in America. It's sort of like what, you know, when Americans were in Vietnam, they were a bit of a, we were big shots, and then a lot of us, when we came back to civilian life, were nothing. And I think that Tommy goes through that change and financial frustration in the States, and I think he represents a lot of what Vietnam veterans went through back here. And I'm not going to tell you the ending, but it does get very complex.
You filmed this in Thailand. Yes. You put a documentary crew in Vietnam to shoot some...
Mm-hmm. Yeah, we have quite a few landscape shots from Vietnam. About 20, 30 shots are in, from beautiful shots of...
Why didn't you shoot it in Vietnam?
Because it's so beautiful. It's an amazing looking place.
Why didn't you shoot this film in Vietnam? Well, rather, why did you shoot it in Thailand?
There's two problems. Where there's a United States embargo still 20 years after the war.
So you couldn't have shot it. The United States would not...
No, and also the Vietnamese government objected, to be honest, to two or three sensitive moments where Lê Lý's book is critical of the Viet Cong. So there was hardliners on both sides in America and in Vietnam. Yeah.
There was also raised in some of the stuff that I read some fear that there would be people who would bear such remembrance of pain that the war had brought to them that they...
I don't think so. I think that what the movie is about healing, and it's about moving on and forgiving your enemy. So, that's what Lely's message is, and I hope people who see the film understand that. If there are people who are going to see it, they're going to be hardline, and they're going to say they're going to become angry in both countries, America and in Vietnam. So, but I think the majority of people will see this as a healing film.
By this film, you complete your sense of what you wanted to say about Vietnam.
I completed, let's say, the personal eyewitness testimony that I've been, I'm from all three sides, Ron Kovic, my own, and I think that there's, you know, you can do the macro picture of what the commanders were going through, what the politics were. See, Vietnam, to me, they keep saying, you know, it's, why are you so obsessed? It's not like I am that obsessed, I don't think. I do feel that Vietnam is a state of mind. It's not a piece of history only, it's a state of mind, because it's about America intervening in third world countries. It's about America being a global cop, not working with the United Nations, just going in and intervening, and not knowing the country that you're intervening in, not understanding the local spiritual values or culture, whether it be Mogadishu or Panama or Vietnam. This thing is going to go on and on. We've had six or seven interventions since Vietnam.
Speaking of that, you're making a film about Noriega?
Yeah.
With Al Pacino in the lead, playing Noriega?
Yeah, looks like it.
Go ahead.
It looks like we go next May in Panama.
Essentially an autobiography, I mean a biographical.
Not really. It's more the last couple of years of the regime when things got crazy. And it really is satiric in tone. It's not quite like the investigative JFK movie. It's more satire.
Well, speaking of JFK, it's inevitable to come to that when you have an interview with you and a conversation with you.